Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about PhotoMaker V2. It's basically a new version of the PhotoMaker model. It's released by the same people at Tencent Arc. They also released PhotoMaker V1 or just PhotoMaker, but that was about 6 months ago. Now we have a version 2. And I'm going to leave all the links in the description below so you can go ahead and read it. Now, just in case if you're new and you're not familiar with PhotoMaker, it's basically going to take a reference image. That's going to be a reference image of a face and pass it through the PhotoMaker model. And it's going to output different images, AI pictures of the same face, but in different settings. It can be different styles. We can have watercolor, digital art, cinematic, but it can also be in different clothes, different settings, different backgrounds, and so on. So you can see an example here. There's another example. This one is basically different styles. And here's one more example. If you are a regular viewer of the channel, you know that I like to do more of ComfyUI tutorials, but this video will not be about ComfyUI. Unfortunately, PhotoMaker V2 is not out on ComfyUI, which is surprising because most new project comes out in ComfyUI first and then goes into different applications such as Focus or Automatic 1111. But this time, this is a standalone project. Now, this project will require some high system requirements. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to showcase PhotoMaker V2 using Hugging Face Space. All right, so as the time of recording, we have a Hugging Face Space where we can test out PhotoMaker. And I'm going to leave this in the description below. If it is still available when you're watching the video, you can try it out. Now, at the top, it tells us that the main purpose of PhotoMaker is to retain the face fidelity as high as possible. So it's going to try to keep the face as similar as possible when outputting different images. Now, as with PhotoMaker V1, we require the class word, which is man, woman, or girl. And then we also need the trigger word, which is IMG. So all the prompts will be a, let's say, for example, in this case, we are going to say a photograph of A, and then we need this class word. I'm going to go with woman, and then we need the trigger word, which is IMG. Whatever comes next, you can keep on adding, let's say, digital art or something else, right? Just keep on adding there. But this part is very important. Now, if you want a picture of a man, then just replace woman with man, but do make sure to have IMG following that class word. Now, using this is very simple. All you need to do is to drop your image here. This can be an AI generated image, or it can be a photo that you've taken. All right, so I've added an image here. I have my prompt, a photograph of a woman, IMG. I'm going to change the style from photographic default to no style. And then I'm going to change the aspect ratio to maybe something like a portrait. Let's try this one. And then I'm going to click on submit. Now this generation is going to be fast because it's running on zero here. That's basically Hugging Face GPU. But if you're trying the project on your own, make sure that you have the system requirements. I believe somebody mentioned in comments somewhere, they mentioned that they were not able to run this project on an 8 GB VRAM card. Okay, so as you can see, it generated, we got two images, and this is the reference image. These two are the generated image. I'm going to leave it to you to judge whether it's the same person, the same face. Now, if you want to improve the face fidelity, it tells you here that you can upload more than one photo. And at the top as well, there is a note that tells us that one image is okay, but more is better. And the project do not do any face detection. So when you're uploading your image, just make sure that you crop it so that the face is the main focus. Now, next, I'm going to show you the different styles. So this comes with built-in styles. You can, let's say, for example, we select digital art, click on submit. And now what's going to happen is that the same thing with SDXL styler inside of ComfyUI, or if you have automatic 1111, there's a dropdown for styles. Focus as well has a dropdown for style. That's the same thing. It's just adding additional tokens at the end of your prompt based on the style template. So instead of selecting a digital art, I could go up here, I could go and type in all these different trigger words. But since we have a template, we can use that. And as you can see, now we have something in the digital art. Now, what's new in PhotoMaker V2 is that if you go down, it tells us that PhotoMaker will generate based on your doodle, and it's going to use the T2i adapter. So let's enable the drawing. And we have a drawing. In the GitHub example, it shows that if you draw a cat, it's going to add like the person holding a cat. So I'm going to try that. Okay, so maybe not, because I'm not able to draw, as you can see, like it's not showing anything. Instead, I'm going to show you the example that they showed. Unfortunately, I will not be able to try it, but if you're able to draw here, definitely try it. Okay, so here's the example that they show. Now, this example, it's basically the same project. Here, they've added an image, they've said their prompt, and they are drawing the cat and generating the image. We can see that character, basically the same person, is now holding a cat. And if they draw two cats, change the prompt, generate a new image, now we have the person holding two cats. So if you're able to draw on that canvas, try it out and let me know if it actually works like this, because I've done a couple of generation and the face was not exactly the same. So maybe they are using a reference image that they've already trained on. I'm not sure, but the results I got were not exactly like these ones. Now, they've also done a comparison. Here we have the reference face. This is PhotoMaker version 1. And they are comparing it with IP adapter face ID. Now, I wish they use IP adapter face ID V2, because that's the latest version and it works best, I think. But they mention only IP adapter face ID. So I'm guessing this one is version 1. Now they are comparing it with Instant ID, and then we have PhotoMaker V2. So we can see that Instant ID and PhotoMaker V2 results are the best. PhotoMaker V2, at least in this particular reference, it's better. So here's another one. Okay, so a couple of examples more, and you can look at these references and maybe judge which one is better. Now, when it comes to ComfyUI, although you can download the model, you can place it inside of ComfyUI models, PhotoMaker, and you will see the model here. So PhotoMaker V2, if you try selecting it and generating an image with it, you are going to get an error. And basically it's because this node here, the PhotoMaker encode plus node, has not been updated for the past 6 months. So and we'll just have to wait until maybe the author here picks up the project and decides to update it for V2, or maybe someone else picks up the project and updates it. Until then, if you'd like to use PhotoMaker inside of ComfyUI, you will have to go with the PhotoMaker V1. And I have done multiple videos on PhotoMaker version 1 in the past. So there's this one here, which says the official ComfyUI PhotoMaker for stable diffusion. This basically will show you the installation, and then I'll also show you a workflow that you can use. And then there's also this one, Stylize Your Photo and ComfyUI PhotoMaker. This also, I show you an easier way of installing the PhotoMaker custom node using the ComfyUI manager. So either one they are both going to give you the same information. And I have an example here. I've used the same person, the same picture. Here's a result. So I think like version one as well is pretty good when it comes to the face fidelity. You'll need to play around with the SDXL base model that you will be using, but otherwise you should get pretty good result. And here's another example. Again, the same reference image. And one more example here. All right, so that is it for today's video. I hope you've enjoyed it and learned a little bit about PhotoMaker V2. I'm going to keep an eye on the ComfyUI implementation. If we get a ComfyUI implementation of PhotoMaker V2, I'm going to make another video and follow up on this topic. I would like to say a big thank you to all of you. The channel has grown to 2,850 subscribers. So big thank you to all of you. If you have not subscribed and you are enjoying the video, click on the subscribe button. You will keep on getting the same type of video. A big shout out to all of my Patreon members who joined and are supporting the channel there. All right, so that is it. Let me know your experience with PhotoMaker. Are you still using PhotoMaker V1? Because that came out 6 months ago. So I'm curious how many of you have incorporated PhotoMaker in your workflow. By the way, a note here, PhotoMaker, whether it's version 1 or version 2, the code base is free to use, but because PhotoMaker itself uses Inside Face, and the Inside Face license says that the models for Inside Face are under non-commercial research purposes only. This means that PhotoMaker as well will need to comply to that same license. So that's something that you'll need to be aware of. Thank you for watching. Give it a like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.